I'll show you how to erase your iPhone before selling it. I'll give you the steps you need to do before selling or giving away your iPhone. In summary, you'll need to back up your iPhone or transfer it to a new one, then unpair, say, your Apple Watch, sign out of Apple ID and iCloud, then go ahead and erase your iPhone and do a factory reset. I'll also show you a different method, which is a shortcut on how to prepare your iPhone before selling it that only takes 1 minute. Now let's get into it. Quick note, if you have already got a new iPhone and you're deleting your old iPhone like I am here, there is an option under settings where it asks you to give you step-by-step instructions to prepare the phone to be sold. So you can follow that by pressing get started and do all of these things here. However, I like to be safe and make sure that I've done it personally. So if you're happy, you've backed up everything and you want to trust Apple to do this, then go ahead and do this method. However, if you haven't already transferred things to your new phone, here's how you do it. So first you want to go ahead and back up your iPhone or transfer it to your new iPhone. So to back up, you can either go through iCloud. So if you've got enough storage on your iCloud, you can back up your iPhone that way. However, if you don't have enough iCloud storage, then what you'll need to do is go into your computer and use iTunes to then upload or back up all of your content from your iPhone to the hard drive on your computer via iTunes. However, as I said before, if you're transferring things to a new iPhone, what you can do is get that new iPhone, bring it next to your old iPhone while it's asking you to set things up, and it will automatically transfer the contents from your old iPhone to your new iPhone. So once that's been transferred, what I do is I recommend you use your new iPhone just for a week or two to make sure that all of your apps and settings have been, you know, transferred over, all the passwords. Particularly, for example, Google Authenticator, if you delete that without transferring your permissions to your new device, I think you lose that forever. So be very careful with that one. Next thing you want to do if you've got an Apple Watch is unpair your Apple Watch from this phone. So I think I've already done that for this phone. Yes, I have. If I hadn't, it would come up and you'd be able to see that I've got this Apple Watch still paired with this phone, and you'll have to go ahead and unpair it so that it doesn't recognize it anymore. Okay, once you're sure that you've backed everything up or transferred everything that you want to, you've taken off your Apple Watch, you've tested out your new phone and you're all happy, then go ahead and do the following steps. Head into settings, we'll come over and tap your name, and then all the way down the bottom, you wanna tap sign out. And what this will do is it will sign out of the App Store, Find My, Media and Purchases, iCloud, and family sharing and anything else that's connected. So we'll go ahead and tap sign out. You'll need to put in your password, so I'll just go ahead and put that in and then press turn off and then just wait for that to happen. Now it's asking for this and I don't want to do that, so I'll make sure these are still disabled and then I'll confirm by pressing sign out. And now we wait for the magic to happen. This could take up to a minute or two depending on how much content you've got through the iCloud server. Okay, so that's fully done. You can see here that it says sign into your phone. That means that at the moment, nothing is currently connected. So if I tap that now, you can see that by signing into Apple ID, you'll get iCloud, App Store, iTunes, iMessage, Find My, and Wallet. So everything that's associated with any of those apps has now been disconnected or signed out. So that's a good confirmation. Next thing you want to do is go into your new iPhone or your iPad or your Mac and then head into settings and tap your name, and now you can see all of the devices that have been connected to your iCloud server. And previously this phone here, the old one, showed up in this list, but now that has been taken off of there, so that step's already done as well, but it's good to do this step just to check anyway. So before you go ahead and do the actual erase all data and contents and settings, you want to just do another double check in your mind that you've got everything on your new phone or it's backed up to a place that you trust, and maybe just go through all your apps visually and just see if that triggers you into thinking, oh, maybe I haven't transferred some of the data from there. Okay, it's now time to do that final step of erasing the iPhone. So hit settings, then come on down to general, all the way down the bottom, it's got transfer or reset iPhone. Now, if you have not been able to successfully do the transfer from your old phone to new phone, this is how you're gonna do that. Otherwise, now I'm ready to go ahead and do this. So I can either reset, which is just gonna reset the factory settings. But what I actually wanna do is erase all content and settings to make sure that the next person using this phone has absolutely none of my information or apps on there. So we'll go ahead and do that. And this is just another check to make sure. Okay, so I've got an eSIM on here as well instead of a hard SIM. Now, if you've got a hard SIM card, you'll have to take that out before you sell the phone as well. And it's showing that it's got apps and data to delete as well. And you'll notice that these two items appeared at the very start of the video when I showed you the automatic way to do it when I had the four options there. So those two items have been taken away manually and the phone recognizes that it's just these two left to do. So now we'll go ahead and continue. I'll just put the passcode in and then you get this message. Yes, I definitely do because I have gone through everything many times. So let's erase data and also erase the eSIMs. So that's another important step to do as well. You don't want to have your own eSIM left on here in case the next person is able to access that. So we'll select erase data and eSIMs here. And now it goes ahead and it will delete and reboot the phone. While that's happening, we can just make sure that there's definitely no SIM card in here, and there is not, so that's all good. And now we'll just wait for the magic to happen. And there we go, there's a pretty quick process, but now you can see that we are back to a fully fresh and ready to sell iPhone. Now that you know what to do before selling or giving away your iPhone, watch this video next to learn how to set iPhone ringtone to any song on your new iPhone. It's quick and easy and really personalizes your phone. So click that now and I'll see you there.